Jerry Pax from Gaming Shogun. We're here with Graham Marquet of Natsumi, and he's going to tell us a little bit about Africa. How are you doing, Graham?
I'm doing well, and yourself?
Doing okay. How's this expo going for you guys so far?
So far, so good. It's good. I'm glad it's back in full swing again.
Yeah, it feels much better, much better.
A lot of great, exciting games, too. So.
Absolutely. So tell us a little bit about Africa.
By all means, Africa, it's a PS3 exclusive game. You play a photojournalist, and your object is to go out and accomplish different missions that your editor sends you. There's over 100 different missions in the game.
Very cool. And now, you have a lot of real cameras, actually licensed cameras in the game. Can you tell us a little about those?
That's right. There's actually 3 licenses in the game. There's the Sony license to all the cameras and the lenses. There's a National Geographic license for the video, the live pictures, and the data. And there's also a Suzuki license.
That's amazing. Now, any word on how many missions exactly you can go on, or can the game go on indefinitely?
There's actually over 100 missions. There's kind of core missions that push you along through the game, opening other areas with other kind of animals. There's over 70 animals in the game. And also at the same time, there's kind of side missions as well.
But what kind of side missions? Just different, getting different
right.
things?
Right, so you know, you'd probably have to look for a cheetah at night, and then you take that picture. One thing that's been added to this game that wasn't in the release in Japan is also has a trophy system as well.
Oh, wow. Now, will there be any type of online social leaderboard system to see who can take the better photos, anything like that?
Yeah, unfortunately not, which is a good idea, but that kind of brings to the nice thing is that Africa is a real easy game to pick up and play, but at the same time, it's as complex as you want to make it. If you'll notice, you could change the shutter speed, the exposure, the frame rate, and then so you can actually learn how to take better pictures by playing Africa.
That's very cool. Now, I notice it looks dusk or dawn at this point. Is it a real day and night cycle?
That's right. So you can get up in the morning, sunrise, sunset. You can also go take pictures at night. The weather conditions change as well.
That's awesome. Very cool. And is it, you said these are different areas in Africa. Are these modeled after real areas or are they fictional?
Well, obviously you have these 5 different areas. So you'd be in one that's kind of a desert where you'd see maybe a meerkat or a cheetah. And then you go to another area with a little bit more swamp with flamingos, hippos. So kind of Africa compressed in this sort of little area. So you unlock these different 5 stages.
That's cool. And is there any danger at all to the photographer? I mean, can you get close to something that will potentially gore
you? They'll charge you, but you know, it fits with the whole Natsume line. Is it non-violent? You just pass out, wake up, back at base camp.
That's awesome. And when's the expected release window for this?
We're looking at August.
August.
2009.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate it, Graham.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it as well.
Jerry Paxton for Gaming Shogun.